My bride's been out here weeding today, and she said, you know, these squash plants, these are the ones that run under the cloches. She said, they really look a whole lot like cucumbers. And guess what, folks? They got tendrils on them. I gave my son the seeds to put in this row with my redneck seed planter because he's going to have a big garden this year, and he wanted to see how we did it, although he lived around us all his life, and like most kids, they didn't fool much with the garden. But now we got a problem. We got a whole row of cucumbers and none of squash, so we got to plant the squash. And I would say that's probably old people's disease on my part. Can't tell the difference. See, if I was planting them, I'd have known it was a cucumber seed and not a squash seed by looking at it, but my son is not a gardener yet, and he just put the seeds in the ground I gave him. And this is where we were going to put some more cucumbers, and it's about time to plant them because we try to stagger them every 2 weeks. So we're going to pull those fences up and put those cucumbers through the fences up to here and put up a couple more sections and just have a whole row. The only handicap is we're only going to have 3 or 4 plants for 10 feet of fence, which is way open spacing for cucumbers. At least we'll get to eat them. Well, that's how much weeds can grow up on one little 16-foot fence that you were planning on putting some cucumbers in, 2 to 4 weeks after you put these over here in. Rather than pull the weeds, we just pull the fence. Since those squash plants we have over there are really cucumbers, we moved that fence over to there and added 2 more sections to it. We'll go on the back side of that and plant some more cucumbers, because they're way too widely spaced. Anyway, we're getting ready to go up the country, as they would say, go back home. Slowly but surely. It's 92 degrees out here today, so this stuff ought to start growing. You can see the 2 tallest tomatoes I have in there. One's on the other end are shorter because it's not as good a soil down there, but these are eye level. Well, heading back home. Thanks for watching. The garden's planted except this partial row that have these 2 tomatoes in them that were sacrificials and one little marigold. So we got to plant this row out to the end. When we pull these onions in a couple weeks, that'll give us another row. There's another row here, but I don't want to do much in there. I'm scared to even cut that grass back there, weeds, because of the yellow jackets. And if I don't start catching them, I'm going to buy that spray that you put up in a hole and wear a lot of clothes and gloves and see if that'll kill them, because I got to get rid of this compost and put it on my garden and put some in the new compost pile so that I can plow these other rows up. And our experiment is definitely getting smaller. It's changed its shape. Doesn't feel mushy yet, but I'm sure it's working. That's the grass just from yesterday. And right now I got to go get the wire and put the wire on those poles and plant 2 grapevines. Well, it's 10 minutes to 12 here on the East Coast. My big old fig tree, I did look up the leaf on it. It's part of the common variety of figs. It has 5 lobes on the leaves. And the truck going behind me on the road. Just to give you some idea of how much these have grown, because if you've looked at the other videos, you know how tall they were when they went in and how tall they are now. Because this is at camera height. You'll notice that this fig tree is blocking the sun on my garden. You have to pay attention to that, because you can see how many of these are shaded. But the ones that are shaded are fairly tall.